pass on this one.
Oh, hey.
Not for long. Well shot! Where did you learn that? Hunting orcs.
The Arbiter can help fire me forever, Elf. You and I will have our day. Let's keep moving.
Four of them! Come on! Which of you filth dies first today?
Athel, we really don't have time for this.
Very well. Take them. By the light, I'm glad you're on our side.
Yes, just one big happy family, mortal. Move along. The sooner we win, the sooner I'm free of you.
Spread out. The artifact should be here somewhere.
Dragon has a weak spot. If I can hit it just right.
I think I like this dragon.
Well, that could have gone better. Any ideas?
We attack together. On three. For Teleria! For the Arbiter!
I thought these champions may have been the ones. Yet it seems I have failed. They were not ready. Teleria is dying, consumed by war and discord. Even now, dark forces in the service of Siroth spread a foul shadow from the east. As guardian of Teleria, I have done what I can, but my power is almost spent. This task now falls to you. I have strength left to restore only one fallen champion to aid you. With their shard remade, they will be bound to your will. But you must choose. Awaken, warrior. This is your bastion. From here, you will summon and train champions to fight the Dark One and his shadow. You have chosen your first champion, but one champion is not an army. Use a mystery shard to summon another champion at the portal. Mystery shards allow you to summon common, uncommon, and rare champions. Excellent. You summoned an attack-type champion with great attack and support skills. Let's head to the campaign map and prepare your champions for their first taste of combat. Behold, Karok Castle, seat of King Tabor. This is where your journey begins. I fear that the king and his bannerlords have fallen to the shadow. Once noble and just, he has brought war upon his allies and ruin on his people. You and your champions must fight through his bannerlords, find him, and see if he has turned to Siroth.
Eleven. 7 generations of peace had reigned between the kingdom of Karak and the realm of Aravia. A peace now shattered by King Taba's brutal campaign of expansion into the neutral lands between the two kingdoms. Once revered as a pillar of justice, King Taba had imposed crushing taxes to finance his war with his former ally, bringing desolation and ruin upon his own people. Had the king lost all reason? On the orders of the Arbiter, the company set out to persuade him to renounce his folly and wayward policies, even if it meant storming the very gates of Karak Castle.
Karak will not fall easily. Like all places in Teleria, there are multiple stages of defenders. You must defeat all stages to move forward with your journey. This is where you select your team and review the enemy champions before each battle. Each champion has unique skills and an affinity that makes them weak or strong against another affinity. Magic beats spirit, spirit beats force, force beats magic, and void is special. Void champions have no direct weaknesses against other affinities. You have only 2 champions. Let us pick your team. Well done. Notice that your leader has an aura skill. These provide special bonuses to all allied champions in a battle. Above each enemy's head show how your champion's affinity matches up against theirs. An affinity advantage means a more effective attack, more damage, and a higher chance to crit. Drop artifacts, and here's your first. Artifacts are powerful items that boost your champion's stats. Along with special items, your champions will earn XP after every battle. Earn enough and they'll level up, growing in strength and power. Go to your champion collection and equip that artifact. This is where you can view all champions under your control. Each champion can equip up to 6 artifacts. Select the artifact and equip your champion. See that? Your artifact has already strengthened this champion. Better yet, artifacts can be equipped in sets to provide special bonuses and effects. I believe you are ready. Return to Karak Castle, seat of King Taba of Karak. Fight through his banner lords and find him. I must know if he has succumbed to the shadow.
Thank you.
happens, you leveled up. Every time you level up, you'll get full energy, gems, and sometimes you'll even unlock new features. And here are your rewards from battle. With this artifact, you'll have enough to equip a full set. Let's go. Artifacts can be equipped individually, but come in set. Special icons will show which artifact sets a champion is equipped with. Tap on the set icon to read more about which bonuses it gives to your champions. This set boosts your champion's HP by 15%. Life artifacts come in sets of two, meaning you can gain a huge 45% HP boost with three sets. Let's upgrade this artifact and improve its bonuses. Excellent work. When you upgrade artifacts to certain levels, they gain new substats, giving your champions an even bigger boost. You have learned well. Keep strengthening your warriors. I shall return in time to teach you more.
castle's guard. The company leader called to mind how the banner lords had cried out their allegiance to their king, but also to Seroth. Was the king's warring folly prompted by the will of the Lord of Darkness? Upon interrogation, a fallen knight confessed that the king had not been seen at the castle for many a month. His orders were being relayed by messenger from his encampment on the eastern front. This meant only one thing. The company would have to pass through the war-torn city of Arnok. Had fallen into ruin, famine, and great sorrow. Peopled by desperate refugees, it had become an unclean place made darker by unknown horrors spawned in the encroaching shadow. To go through it safely would take days, to go round it much longer, so the company agreed to pass beneath it. They would venture into the foul city sewers, albeit risking the known danger of intruding on the territory of the lizard men. dispatching the lizard men tainted by the shadow, the company waylaid a messenger bearing a missive from the king. They demanded that he direct them to the royal encampment. Trembling for his life, the emissary pleaded that he knew nothing of such a camp. He had only ever received the sealed messages from a hooded knight at the catacombs of the Temple of Narbach. Emerging from the sewers, the company set their compass northeastward and began a long and arduous trek to the castle. Consecrated to the cult of Suroth. Guided by their torches, they entered the catacombs where the wind howled with the anguished screams of the restless dead. As they sank deeper into the vaulted galleries, a voice on the wind became ever more distinct, now echoing words of protest, now prayers to Lamea, the goddess of light. We'll be right back. The company crashed into a chamber to find King Taba strapped to a chair, his captors forcing a brew down his throat. They made short work of the aggressors, then cut the king from his binds.
I have been bewitched,
he began in rasping breaths.
Forced to declare war on Aravia.
Then, handing them his royal signet, he said,
ask Queen Eva forgiveness for my forced betrayal. Thank her for giving refuge to my people, and request her help to find the cause of this shadow.
Into Aravia, they would have to pass through the dark wood to Felwyn's gate. After a three-day trek, they reached the edge of Durham Forest, home of the Dark Elves. The Elves promised safe passage to those who would pay the toll. Showing them the signet of the king, the company claimed right of way as bearers of the monarch's word. But the Dark Elves recognized neither king nor queen, and attempted to take their toll in blood.
Yeah.
ugly truth of the Dark Elves was now known. Preying on the desperation of the refugees, they had offered two paths. The rich man's path, offering safe passage to Felwyn's Gate, and the poor man's path, leading to the belly of the dragon. The company blazed ahead to meet the Elven Queen of Aravia, an ancestral ally of Kirok. Known for her exceptional beauty, she was also a famed mistress of the old magic. So our heroes joined the torrent of hopeful exiles traveling eastward to the promise of sanctuary among the High Elves. Down to Felwyn's Gate, the company surveyed the grim scene before them. A multitude of half-starved refugees. Human folk, lizard men, elven, the many peoples of Teleria, all camped in the frozen mud outside the battlements of the Great Gate, now barred. Ogryn and Skinwalker guards were denying them entry, telling them to clear off back to their homelands. The company agreed to force their way through and unbar the passage.